Hyaluronic acid is there in every single product these days, so let's see why. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Akanksha. I'm just feeling like, you know, a little gangster vibes today. Just too lazy to change my clothes, so I just added this necklace and red lip. Kind of looks like a little, you know, cool kid, gangstery type of vibe, but I really like how it looks. So before getting into the video, I just want to give a big disclaimer. I'm not a dermatologist, I have nothing. This is just for me, you know, to share whatever knowledge I have about, you know, certain ingredients or skincare, what I researched. I'm just going to share it with you. I'm not dermatologist, I'm not claiming to be. So if you have any skin issues or anything of that sort, I don't think I can help you. I can just share the knowledge I have so that you can just see if it is useful for you. So saying that, I'm going to start a series where I'm going to break down each and every active in your skincare ingredient. You guys requested me a lot, you know, break down skincare ingredients and explain as much as I can so that you can decide whether or not you want them in your skincare. So I'm just going to share you guys whatever I have, the knowledge I have. I'm going to do the best to give you everything right and as much as information as I can. Like you read the title of the video, today's video is going to be about hyaluronic acid. So like that, you know, next videos might be about vitamin C, AHA, BHA, so anything of that sort. I'm not sure yet, but today's video is about hyaluronic acid. So if you're interested in skincare, you have heard this name a hundreds of times, hyaluronic acid. So let's get into the video and see why the hell is hyaluronic acid so hyped. Is it really worth it? Do you really have to have in your skincare and all of that sort. So let's start off with what is hyaluronic acid. Hyaluronic acid or HA is something which is naturally present in our skin. So it is basically a sugar component which is there in our skin. A maximum amount of HA in our body is during the time we were like born, when we were babies. We do have a high amount of hyaluronic acid in our body, and so as you age, the amount of hyaluronic acid keeps decreasing, so you need to add it topically or with fillers so to retain the moisture in your skin. So hyaluronic acid basically draws moisture from the air and pulls it in your skin and makes your skin stay hydrated and plump. So hyaluronic acid is so high because it can hold 100 times its weight in water. Sorry guys, I just mispronounced it. It's not 100, hyaluronic acid holds 1000 times its weight in water. So 1 gram of hyaluronic acid can hold up to like 1000 grams of water in its weight. So the most common terms you have for hyaluronic acid in the ingredient list is it's normally just, you know, written as hyaluronic acid, or it's usually most commonly written as sodium hyaluronate. So these are the two things which are most commonly written on the ingredient label. So if they basically see sodium hyaluronate, means that, you know, it is hyaluronic acid. Hyaluronic acid is very jelly type in texture. Hyaluronic acid is really good for hydrating your skin and making it plump and nice, but you need to be really careful on whether or not you can use a hyaluronic acid depending on your surroundings. If you're somebody who stays in a very dry area, you cannot use a hyaluronic acid, because usually what hyaluronic acid does, it you know, pulls the moisture from the air and helps your skin stay hydrated. So if you're somebody who's in a very humid area or etc., it's really good, it's going to retain the moisture. But if you're somebody who's in a very dry area, it doesn't have moisture from the air to draw, so it can draw from your skin, which can kind of make your skin more dehydrated, which is not very ideal. So you need to be very mindful of whether or not, you know, you can use your hyaluronic acid depending on where you stay or live. So hyaluronic acid and glycerin are kind of similar. They both draw the air from they both draw moisture, water from the air and like hydrate your skin. Glycerin has been an old friend which has been here since ages. Glycerin is always almost present in all the skincare products because it's a very good humectant as well. It's a cheaper version and it does the job like same like hyaluronic acid. But the major difference between glycerin and hyaluronic acid is their molecular weight. Hyaluronic acid is known to have higher molecular weight, whereas glycerin has known to have like smaller molecular weight. So it's not that because of the small molecular weight of glycerin, it seeps through the skin really well and like plump and hydrate from within, whereas hyaluronic acid, due to the higher molecular weight, sits on the surface of the skin and provides that instant like hydration which is required. So there are types of hyaluronic acid as well. So there are topical serums one and there are fillers. So the fillers doesn't really mean like, you know, you're adding a layer or, you know, carving your face or anything of that. So there are hyaluronic acid fillers just to make your skin really hydrated and everything. So once you start aging, or you know, as you age, you tend to lose a lot of hyaluronic acid from your skin. So that makes your skin lose its elasticity as well, because it doesn't have any enough hydration in it to retain its elasticity or collagen. So if when you apply hyaluronic acid topically, it is said that it only reaches like, you know, until your epidermis and that's it. So like, you know, basically we have skin layers, there's epidermis, then dermis. When you apply it topically, it only reaches until the top layer of the epidermis and it doesn't go until the dermis layer. So fillers are something which help, you know, you to give hyaluronic acid until the dermis layer, and you know, it helps rejuvenate from the skin from the inside. So these fillers can last up to, like, I guess 6 to 18 months. I'm not sure, I'm not going to go into the fillers part a lot because I'm not a dermatologist and I don't know, but it's something people can opt for if you want that really nice plumpy skin, you know, from within. It really really helps a lot. I've heard about it. So for topical, there are types, there, you know, creams you can use which have hyaluronic acid, and you can use serums which you have hyaluronic acid. But if you go with serums, it's not really enough. You always have to top it off with a moisturizer, because hyaluronic acid will help you pull the moisture into the skin, but and the moisturizer will just lock everything in place. Hyaluronic acid is an active, but it just that it doesn't exfoliate your skin, or it doesn't, like, you know, brighten up your skin or anything of that sort. It's not going to irritate your skin in any matter. Most of the people can use hyaluronic acid. I would say 95%. There are very very rarely cases where hyaluronic acid doesn't suit your skin, and because it's a very gentle humectant, it does nothing but just hydrate your skin and make it really plump and nice. So though it's an active, it's usually not considered an active because it doesn't have any irritation or anything to the skin at all. Hyaluronic acid is something which is very versatile. You can use it with literally anything. You can use it with AHAs, you can use with BHAs, vitamin C's, retinols. You can use it with anything because it just helps retain moisture in place and hydrates your skin. All skin types can use hyaluronic acid, let it be sensitive skin, acne prone skin, oily skin, dry skin. Anybody can use hyaluronic acid because it's just a human. Thin. Just hydrate your skin, and hydrating your skin is never too bad. But make sure you don't overdose your skin with hyaluronic acid. Just use like one hyaluronic acid moisturizer or serum which has good amount of hyaluronic acid in it, and that would be enough for, you know, to hydrate your skin. So I've heard few doctors even say that, you know, you should not spend a lot of money for a hyaluronic acid, because hyaluronic acid is something which is like, you know, topical, and you wash it away, it's not going to like give you a long term effect. Hyaluronic acid is pretty cheap. You can get it in, like, you know, a fair amount of deal. You don't have to spend like $100, $200 on a hyaluronic serum. You can rather, you know, if you really want that hydration, maybe you have to get fillers. That's what I've heard few doctors say. And hyaluronic acid is cheap. It's available in a lot of forms these days. So make sure you do have a product which has really high amount of hyaluronic acid in it, so that, you know, your skin will stay nice and hydrated and plump all the time. You don't want to age really quickly. So I have two products to show to you which I really like, which have a good amount of hyaluronic acid. So one is the ordinary one, so the ordinary 2% HA. I really really like it. It's something which hydrates your face. It's a very very simple hyaluronic acid, does the job pretty quick, and I really like it. Then one more is what I've been trying recently. This is from Sugandha. It does have enough, like, you know, amount of hyaluronic acid. I don't mention how much, but you know, it has beautiful beautiful ingredients. It has really really calming ingredients and hydrating ingredients. So I really like something. It is not pure just hyaluronic acid, but it's something which would really help in hydrating your skin. So I really really like that one as well. So yeah guys, that's it for the video. I hope it was useful. I hope you learned something about the hyaluronic acid, and if you did, make sure you like, share, subscribe to my channel, ring the notification bell, it'll mean the world to me. And like and comment and let me know what you want to see. Like, if you like, I know that you want me to do more such videos, and comment about what ingredients you want me to review, or like, you know, share my knowledge about. And yeah, that's it for today's video, and see you guys in the next one. Bye.